Hi everybody, my name is Miss Kelsey and I'm a director and an acting teacher at Jeanette Aaron Performing Arts Studios. I'm so excited because today I'm going to teach you how to create a clear character using your face, your voice, and your body. Now you might not know this, but many characters that you meet in plays actually already live inside of you. You have all the ingredients that it takes to completely transform into any character. The way that I like to teach character is to build a character from the inside out. That means that you will take three simple ingredients. You will change the level of your body. That means how low or high your character is standing and moving. You'll change the shape of your body just a little bit to make your character really express who they are and what they're doing in the play. You'll also change your facial expressions to make yourself look and speak like the character you're playing. With levels, shapes, and facial expressions, you can be any character. And like I said, all of these things live inside of you. So today we are going to take our body and transform ourselves into an entire kingdom of characters. That's right, my friends. We are going into the Fairytale kingdom to meet some characters that already live inside of us. It's all about accessing those characters using your levels, shapes, and facial expressions. And of course, by transforming your voice. But the voice will change when your level, your shape, and your expression changes too. So in this kingdom today, we'll call it the Fairytale Kingdom. And in the Fairytale Kingdom, there are many different characters that you're about to meet. In the Fairytale Kingdom, one of the characters we will transform into is the giant. Now, if you're a smaller actor, kind of like me, it might be hard for you to feel like a giant, like someone who is so tall and so strong and so massive that they shake the ground every time they walk. But guess what, actors? You can become the giant. Try this with me. To become the giant in the Fairytale character, we really want to use a low level of sound. So we're going to try to make the giant speak from our low legs and our low belly. To transform into this giant, I like to sit down a little bit into the invisible chair. So I'm sitting down a bit. That really helps me access the muscles in my legs. Once the muscles in my legs are turned on, because I'm sitting down just a little bit, then I can breathe into my legs and use that low belly voice. So my shape is low, my level is low and strong, and when I speak as the giant, I make my face a little more angry. I furrow my brow and I say the words, fee-fi-fo-fum. Notice how I'm stomping my legs as well to make myself feel like I'm shaking the ground like the mightiest giant in the whole kingdom. Try it with me, actors. Bend your knees, sit back into the chair, and stomp your feet as you say the words, fee-fi-fo-fum. So that's where the giant character can live, in our low belly and our legs. A little higher up from the giant lives the king and the queen of the kingdom. If you ever have to play a king or a queen, someone who rules the kingdom, you can try speaking from this spot right here between your belly button and your rib cage is your diaphragm. Now that's a muscle that fills up with air when you take a breath so that you can speak loud and proud just like a king or a queen would. When you put your hand on your belly and make the shape with your arm coming out wide like this, it makes you look like you really are in charge of this kingdom. And you can say this line with me to play the king or the queen. I rule this kingdom. The voice is a little higher than the giant, but we still have a very serious face, a very serious, nice, proud, loud voice. And when we make the shape of our body extend our arm out wide, We look important. We look very, very royal. So let's put it together, starting with the first character we met in the fairy tale kingdom. Let's start with the giant. Fee, fi, fo, fum. Now the king and queen. I rule this kingdom. Talk about facial expressions. As the king or queen, you can imagine there's a crown on the top of your head, keeping your head up very straight and tall. Your eyebrows can come up a little bit too, to show that you are watching everything. Try it with me. I rule this kingdom. Another character we meet in the fairy tale kingdom of characters is the prince or the princess. Now, the prince or the princess, they're not as regal and royal as their mother and father. They don't rule the kingdom yet. In fact, we say that they speak from their chest, and they speak with a little bit more energy and a bit higher of a sound. But to really transform into that prince or princess, we need to really put on our bossy boots. We need to be standing up, maybe even balling up our fists, maybe even using our eyes and our eyebrows to look a little bit mad, because the prince and the princess want to get whatever they want, and they want it now. They want you to bring them their crown. So that's what we'll say when we transform into the bossy prince or princess. They're kind of spoiled. They're a little bit bossy. They're not always the kindest characters, although we know that princes and princesses are often very nice. But let's try this together. Everyone speaking from the center of their chest, go ahead and point your finger to change the shape to make yourself a bossy character and say it with me. Bring me my crown! Bring me my crown! Now let's go back from the giant to the king and queen to the prince and princess. Try it with me.
Fee, fi, fo, fum!
I rule this kingdom. Bring me my crown! Another character that lives up here in the chest area is the character of the brave knight. Now, the knight is someone who has to save the prince and the princess when they get themselves into trouble for being so bossy and so careless. Oftentimes, the prince or the princess will travel into the woods on their own. And sometimes they come across some bad guys. And that's when the knight has to save them. When we play the knight, we speak from our heart, which is up a little higher than our bossy prince and princess chest placement. Instead of speaking from the middle of our chest, we're speaking from up in our heart. And we can put a smile on our face and let our voice come a little wider from our lips and our eyes, from our mask area. When we say the knight's words, we'll also take the knight's sword and we'll throw it in the air with our fist high. We'll say, I'll save you. Listen to the difference between bring me my crown and I'll save you. The knight speaks with a little bit more air in the back of their throat so that they sound a bit kinder, a bit sweeter and more patient. So when you use a little more air here in the back of your throat, away from the nose and the teeth, that is when we start to sound kind and brave like a knight. Try it with me. I'll save you. A little lower down. Bring me my crown. Even lower than that.
I rule this kingdom. And down at the bottom. Fee, fi, fo, fum.
We've almost met every character in our fairy tale kingdom, but there are two more that I'd love for you to try. Now, the reason the knight has to do so much saving is because in that deep, dark woods where the prince and the princess like to go whenever they want, there is a giant, but there is also a witch, or a wizard if you're a boy. The witch and the wizard live in a cave in the deep dark forest, and they speak from their nose. So when you speak
speak as the witch or the wizard, you'll imagine that your nose is growing into a big warty thing, and all the sound you make is coming from that green witchy warty nose. You can narrow your eyes and make your sharp, terrible teeth pointed, because you are the witch who says, double, double, toil and trouble.
That's a spell, and if you practice your witch character often enough, you could play a witch in many different plays.
So the witch character has a high witchy voice that comes from their nose, and you can take your fingers to make that magic spell. Double, double, toil and trouble.
That's a very famous line from Shakespeare. Your directors will be very impressed if you can say double, double, toil and trouble, just like the witches in the Shakespeare play. So try it with me, boys and girls and friends at home. From the nose, to the heart, to the chest, to the belly, to the legs, we're going to meet all the characters in the fairy tale kingdom by transforming our shape, our voice, our face, our level, and our body. Here we go.
Double, double, toil and trouble.
I'll save you.
Bring me my crown.
I rule this kingdom. Fee, fi, fo, fum.
Nicely done. We have one more character for you to meet,
and this character is the character in the fairy tale kingdom who tells us that everything will be all right. They have a little sprinkle of pixie dust, and once the knight has saved the prince and princess from the giant and the wizard, this character makes us all live happily ever after. This is the character of the fairy.
When I transform into the fairy character, I make the highest voice I can by imagining that my voice is coming out of the top of my head.
By making a tiny voice, a tiny high voice, I sound like a tiny flying fairy.
You can imagine that you're sprinkling that pixie dust on the top of your head to help yourself speak that way from a high level. Your eyes can get wider and a little bit higher. And of course your smile will widen and raise up higher on your face as well, because a fairy flies high in the sky. So her level is high, her shape is high and flying like a pixie. Her level and her, she's a small character, he's a small fairy, so you don't want to boom your voice like a giant, because that will transform you into a bigger character.
By using a high voice,
you make a smaller character. So cool. So try the last one with me, happily ever after, as the fairy.
Happily ever after!
Well done, actors. Now you can shake out all those fairy tale characters, because we're going to practice them one more time from the bottom to the top, and then we'll go from the top to the bottom. Once we're finished, you will be warmed up to play any character, to express your character with levels and shapes, expressions, and different voices. So let's put it together for the last time.
Fee, fi, fo, fum. I rule this kingdom.
Bring me my crown.
I'll save you.
Double, double, toil and trouble. Happily ever after. Happily ever after. Double, double, toil and trouble.
I'll save you.
Bring me my crown.
I rule this kingdom. Fee, fi, fo, fum.
Wow, actors. We have gone through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different characters that you can transform into using that fun acting game. There are so many characters that you can become as long as you remember to change your face, your voice, your body, the level of your body, the shape of your body, and the expressions that you make. Those are some simple ingredients to making a clear character. And I hope to see you very, very soon in the acting studio online. Have a wonderful day.